In this scenario, a patient presents with a Kennedy class 3 modification 1 arch form.
18 and 31 are severely tipped mesially and lingually. There are no restorations in these teeth. 22 and 27 are lingually tipped with no buccal undercut. The patient does not desire implants or fixed partial dentures. The patient is very aesthetic conscious. 22 and 27 each have a bulky cingulum. 5 mm exist between the elevated floor of the mouth and the free gingival margin of the anterior teeth. The periodontal prognosis of the remaining teeth is good.
Posterior support for the partial denture will be provided by the extended occlusal rest on the molars. Anterior support will be derived from the cingulum rests. It is useful to simulate irreversible procedures on a duplicate, mounted diagnostic cast. Long guiding planes are prepared on the distal of the cuspid as well as the mesial of the molar. Parallel guide planes define the path of insertion and dislodgement of the partial denture and reduce the likelihood of food entrapment. Parallel proximal plates limit potential rotation of the framework in function and provide frictional resistance to displacement. Guide plane preparation must be carefully considered in the anterior area as over-reduction may be anesthetic.
No undercut is present on the facial of the cuspid. A composite resin restoration is placed to create 0.01 inch retentive undercut. The illustration shows preparation of the rest seats. The severe tilt of the molars precludes clasping of these teeth. The extended occlusal rest helps direct forces down the long axis and limits further tipping.
Ladder retained acrylic bases are used. Placement of the major connector and eyebar retainers is illustrated. A fulcrum line may exist between 22 and 27, but operates in only one direction. The rested lingual plate assists to limit this anterior-posterior motion. Frictional retention of proximal plates and parallelism of guide planes may also prevent lifting of the posterior portion of the denture.
If the plane of occlusion is to be restored, the extended occlusal rest may take the form of an overlay. To resist movement of the rest in the horizontal plane, a 1-2 mm bevel is placed on the buccal and lingual. To resist movement in the sagittal plane, a 1-2 mm guide plane is placed on the mesial. Pits, fissures and grooves should be restored.
The eyebar acquires sufficient vestibular depth, at least 5 mm, minimal soft tissue undercut, and no interfering frenal attachments. If these requirements cannot be met, a small cast circumferential clasp located on the distal portion of the tooth may be aesthetically acceptable.